mother came from Ireland when she was 14 years old, and her family immigrated to the United States, and they settled in Central Texas. And she was just about as Irish as you could be her whole life. And she used to make a dish called Bubble and Squeak. It was made of cabbage and potatoes and onions and things like that, and it was an ideal dish during the Depression, when those things were fairly easy to come by. And I went through the refrigerator, and we have cabbage, potato, green pepper, onion, and some Texas hot links. You can use any kind of sausage you want in there, but I just happen to have this and like them. You can use smoked sausage or German sausage or any kind of sausage like that. I have about a tablespoon of bacon grease that I've melted in here. Bacon grease just gives it a flavor that you can't get anywhere else. You can use any kind of oil that you wanted to in there, but that's my preference. And I've cut up the potato and the cabbage, so it goes in. Next is the chopped up onion. And nothing is complete without some garlic. And cut the sausage in about 1/4 inch wide pieces. There's one trying to escape, another one's going to get it. This sausage here is Earl Campbell's Texas Hot Links. I really like them. They've got a great flavor and just enough spice in them to make them interesting. And this goes on top. And this is about 1/2 cup of water. Get it started with some steam and put a lid on and let it steam. And it's about 30 minutes from now, it'll be ready to eat. About halfway through, you need to uncover this and tumble things in here a little. My grandfather was born in 1876 on July 4th, and they named him George Washington. He and my grandmother got married, and that's when they moved to the town, or they set up there in housekeeping in Shannon, which is just about as Irish as you could get. And they lived there till 1946 when they moved to the panhandle where we were and lived with us and another daughter there for a while. He died shortly after they got there, and my grandmother lived to 94 years old. Well, it's time for some salt and pepper and another turning of it. Speaking of my grandmother, here's a picture of her standing in front of the house in which I was born. It was moved from the ranch into Stinnette in 1939, and my folks lived in it until they died, and it stood vacant for a number of years. It wasn't much of a house, wasn't enough to anybody buy it or anything, but the city finally burned it down, or let the fire department burn it down for practice. We'd moved away and they had lost contact with us, and I don't know if they tried to contact me about destroying the house or not, but it's nothing but a vacant lot now with grass and weeds on it. Okay, give it one final check here and check the potatoes. When they're done, it's ready. And the potatoes are done. So, goes to the table and dinner is ready.